Folks, welcome to our service today for the second Sunday of the Easter season. We are today telling more of the stories of Jesus' resurrection appearances to his first disciples, and I guess connecting with our experience of Jesus in our lives today. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Christ is risen, alleluia. He is risen indeed, alleluia.
Now come and follow me. He surely went with gladness, for there was much to see. He witnessed Jesus' teaching and saw his healing touch. He found a faith to guide him, a friend he loved so much. Thomas dared to say, "We don't know where you're going. How can we know the way?" He wanted understanding of what he could not see. Then Jesus reassured him, "The way is here through me." Leaders raised their cry. Brave Thomas spoke out firmly, "Let's go with him and die." He ate at Jesus' table, partaking wine and bread. Yet later with the others, he saw the cross and fled. What joy on Easter evening, when many saw the Lord. Yet Thomas was not with them, and would not trust their word. When Christ appeared before him, his doubts were quickly gone. He gladly knew that evening the joy of Easter dawn. That man of faith saw Jesus at breakfast by the sea. At Pentecost he witnessed so others would believe.
Our sentence for today. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. Jesus said, This is the great and first commandment, and a second is like it. You shall love your neighbour as yourself. Christ, our Passover lamb, has been offered for us. Therefore, we come to celebrate the festival. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith with a sincere and true heart. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us, strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to God in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sin, strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, the strength of those who believe and the hope of those who doubt, may we who have not seen have faith and receive the fullness of Christ's blessing, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen.
A reading from 1 Peter chapter 1, beginning at verse 1. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to the exiles of the dispersion in Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, and Asia, who have been chosen and destined by God the Father and sanctified by the Spirit to be obedient to Jesus Christ and to be sprinkled with his blood. May grace and peace be yours in abundance. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who are being protected by the power of God through faith, for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, even if now for a little while you have had to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, being more precious than gold, that though perishable is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy. For you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. Concerning this salvation, the prophets who prophesied of the grace that was to be yours made careful search and inquiring about the person or time that the Spirit of Christ within them indicated, when it testified in advance to the sufferings destined for Christ and the subsequent glory. It was revealed to them that they were serving not themselves, but you, in regard to the things that have now been announced to you through those who brought you the good news by the Holy Spirit sent from heaven, things into which angels long to look. Hear the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you, and also with you. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John, the 20th chapter, beginning at the 19th verse. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen, and yet they come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book, but these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This Easter season is all about the resurrection of Jesus, and our life as a community of people who follow him alive in our hearts and in our midst. So today we've read two appearance stories of Jesus appearing at Easter time to his first disciples. On the evening of Easter day, to Peter and most of the disciples, to say, "Peace be with you, I give you the Holy Spirit, go and forgive people." And then to Thomas, one of my favourite stories of Jesus appearing to people, when he says to Thomas, "So you want to put your hand in the holes in my hands and side? Go ahead." And Thomas worships, "My Lord and my God." Jesus appearing to them to tell them that he's alive. All sorts of interesting things about those stories. That Jesus is really alive, that it wasn't just a figment of their hope, that they aren't just stories made up by the church later on, but that the tomb was empty and the women saw that and he was alive and the men and the women met him and that he reigns in heaven. He's really alive, is the point of the Easter stories. But it's interesting if you read the John Gospel that we've had carefully, that he only appears to the disciples every now and again. So on the evening of Easter Day, they've spent probably 12 hours knowing that the angel told the ladies that he's alive, but not seeing him until he just appears in their midst. And then he appears again a week later. What happened in the meantime? They had to learn to believe that he was alive in their hearts and in their midst, without seeing. And so at the end, in the bit of the gospel reading that Robin forgot to read, and there's a second bit, I don't know how well it's going to edit together, we're told that we don't get to see either, but we have to believe because of their testimony that Christ is alive in heaven, in our hearts, and in our midst. Interesting that he only appears intermittently, but he's always here. It's also interesting that when he appears, he gives them peace. Now, peace is not a big theme in John's Gospel. Truth and life are big themes and metaphors for them. The light of the world, the bread of life, the water of life, metaphors for truth and life. But Jesus' promise of peace is only given on that Thursday night before his death in the upper room long sermon, John's 14 through to 17. He promises that they will have peace in the future, and that that peace will be at a time when he's absent from them but present through the Holy Spirit. That the Holy Spirit will teach them to be able to follow him, remember his teaching and apply it to their lives. They'll be able to follow him because they'll have the Holy Spirit. They'll be able to follow him in the face of opposition. They'll be able to live for him in the face of difficulty and temptation and persecution. They'll be able, by the presence of the Holy Spirit, to follow his teaching. And that will be their peace. So when he appeared to them on that Easter evening, and he said, "Peace be with you," and then he breathes on them and says, "Receive the Holy Spirit," he's closing a loop on something he'd promised only three evenings before, that they would have the Holy Spirit, teach them to follow the truth, and that would be their peace in a chaotic world. The peace that he gives is not comfortableness, a warm cuddle from God and everything being okay. The peace that he gives is that they're whole as individuals and as a community following Jesus, come what may, doing church as he had taught them to do for 3 years. That's the peace that he gives. And as the people who follow him, who've learned that he forgave them, so together they will offer his forgiveness to others. In a sense, on that Easter evening, they are introduced to what will be their new normal. Their old normal was following him. He's physically there. They teach, he teaches, they misunderstand, they do, they watch. The new normal for them after his resurrection is that he's in their midst by his Spirit still teaching, and they have to follow by faith and make his love known to others so that others can join and follow by faith and be forgiven. We're in that same kind of situation now as Christians. As the last couple of verses of the gospel point out, we believe in Jesus because of their testimony. The women's testimony, the tomb was empty. Their testimony, they saw him alive. Resonating with our Christian experience that he's in our hearts and in our midst, that he's brought us to forgiveness and new life in the people of God. He rose, and so we live. They, in that 40 days when he was appearing to them after his resurrection, he only appeared every now and again, so we, most of the time, are living by faith. There are times when we feel close to him and know that we're spoken to. And there's other times when we just believe it and get on. They, like we, had to follow the truth as disciples together, and in that way they would know peace. We, like them, have the Holy Spirit. Follow the truth of the apostles in the gospels and in the epistles, and our peace, our wholeness, is to be his disciples, the community of his followers today. They, like we, had a mission to make forgiveness available. We, like them, offer Christ's love and forgiveness to the world. They were opposed. We are sometimes ignored. But Christ is alive in our hearts, in our midst, and reigning in heaven. And he has given us the Holy Spirit so we can know the truth, follow him, love each other and our enemies, and make his risen, loving, forgiving presence known to others. Happy Easter and happy Easter season.
Ubutumwa bwiza tubusanga muri Yohana Mweranda, ikigaburo cya 20, umurongo wa 19. Yesu yereka abigishwa 10. Nuko kuri uwo munsi buhwikiriye, niwo munsi wa mbere w'iminsi indwi, inzugi zari zugaye aho abigishwa bari kubwo gutinya Abayuda. Yesu araza abahagarara hagati, arababwira ati, amahoro abe muri mwebwe. Amaze kuvuga atyo abereka ibiganza byiwe no mu rubavu. Maze abigishwa baranezerwa babonye umwami. Yesu yongera kubabwira ati, amahoro abe muri mwebwe. Nk'uko Data yantumye niko nanje mbatumye. Ati, nimwakire mpemu yera, kandi abo muzoharira ibyaha bose bazoba babihariwe, ariko abo mutazobiharira bose ntibazoba babihariwe. Ibi ni byo byabaye ku mugoroba w'umunsi wa mbere wa Pasika. Yesu yagiye kubigishwa biwe kubiyereka ko ari muzima. Yaberetse ibiguma byari ku maboko, kandi abereka inkovu no mu mbavu, kugira ngo bamenye ko ari we koko, ko yapfuye kandi ko yongeye kuba muzima. Icakurikiyeho yakoze ni ukubaha ibyo bari bakeneye kugira ngo babashe kubaho nk'abakristo. Abenshi muri bo bari barananiwe kuba abayoboke beza ba Yesu igihe yapfa. Amaze kuzuka mu bapfuye, abasubiza mu mwanya wabo nk'abayoboke biwe. Yabahaye amahoro kugira ngo bamenye neza koko ko azokwamana nabo, kandi ntibazigera baba bonyine. Yabasubije ku mirimo yabo mu kubandanya akazi yari yarabatoje. Yabahaye mwemu yera kugira ngo bashobore gutegera ijambo ryiwe, kandi bagire imbaraga zo gukora ibyo yavuze. Insiguro ya Pasika n'imwe ntabwo ihinduka no kuri twebwe. Yesu ni muzima. Ntabwo twigera tuba twenyine. Dufise akazi ko gukora, ari byo gukunda abandi mu izina rya Yesu. Kandi dufise mwemu yera kugira ngo adushoboze kuguma hafi ya Yesu no gukora iby'ijambo ryiwe ritubarira. Muheza agirwe gukura nk'abigishwa. Amina.
Let us together affirm the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Well, we've remembered in the readings and in the sermon that we are called to follow the risen Christ. And we do that together. Let's share the greeting of peace. Christ has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you.
Peace, Robin.
Peace with you.
Tunaimba sifa.
Let us pray to our risen Saviour on behalf of the Church, the world, and all people according to their needs. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, breathe your Holy Spirit upon us like Thomas. We want proof before we commit. Forgive our fears and strengthen our faith. Remind us again and again that your good news is too good not to be true. Fill your church with your peace. We too ask to be filled with the joy and peace of the disciples in seeing the risen Lord. May we in our parish be united in our convictions and love with a common purpose, so that without competition and thinking of other people's interests, we always act with the mind of Christ. May those who enjoy the blessing of a long life, especially grandparents and the elderly, take heart from the words, old age is not a shipwreck, old age is beautiful. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Risen Lord, we pray for a deepening personal relationship with you that can change our lives, and for an openness that inspires us to take our active living faith into our suffering world. Lord, we pray for all those fleeing their homes in Syria, Afghanistan, Somalia, Ukraine, Sudan, Ethiopia, and Iraq, and those European countries which are welcoming them and giving them safe refuge. May NATO bring peace to those parts of the world where it has been absent for far too long. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus said to his disciples, "Peace be with you." This greeting carries the sense of the Hebrew greeting Shalom, and a blessing that connotes more than tranquility, the kind of peace the world cannot give. We pray for the sick in their hour of need, especially if their illness fills them with doubts and fears. May they be aware of your presence holding them and encouraging them towards healing and wholeness. We now pray for all those on our prayer list in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As Jesus shows his disciples his hands and his side so that they can see that he is the real flesh and blood crucified Jesus, and as we remember, before you those who will not journey any more on earth, we thank you for the gift of hope beyond death that you have given us through the life, death and resurrection of your Son. We give thanks and remember the life and witness of Esme Waddington, Gladys Francis Bryce and Fred Taylor. We remember our loved ones and others known to us whose anniversary of death occurs at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we've asked in faith, we may by your grace receive through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amasengesho yo mu kirundi yo kuri munsi w'Imana igerekezo ya 16 z'ukwezi kwa kane umwaka w'2023 na 2023 abereye ku ishengero rya Mariko Mweranda muri Anglican hano muri Australia. Mana ugira neza, Mana y'icubahiro, amashimwe n'aba yawe Mwami. Icubahiro n'ikibi cyawe Mana yacu urabikwiye. Turagushimiye ubuntu bwawe, turagushimiye imbabazi zawe z'amaho Mana yacu. Turagushimiye ko wavuze yuko nitwaguhamagara Mana yacu uzobana natwe tuzotwitaba nitwakurondera tuzokubona mwami turondera umuvyeyi wacu turondera imana yacu dukunda turondera umuremyi wacu mwami none mana yacu imbere ya byose tubanze twicishe bugufi tubanze dusaba imbabazi mwami kuko ijambo ryawe tubwira ngo kuko kwawe ni kwari kugufi ngo nanirwe gukiza ngo n'amatwi yawe ntiyapfuye ngo nanirwe kumva ariko ibigaba bitanyo byacu mwami n'ibicumuro byacu birashobora gutuma utakira amasengesho yacu mwami none abari kubarumviriza aya masengesho yacu abari hafi abari kure mana yacu turuguruye imitima yacu turagomba kuyibamwo mwami yigereremwo hanyuma uduharire ibyaha byacu mwami hama dusabe duhabwe mwami kuko dusaba umuvyeyi wacu mana turagushima dufise ibyizigiro dufise kwizera mana yacu ko wamaze kuduharira kuko wewe uri mana dufise isezerano wadusezeraniye mwami ngo nitwizera tukezira izina ryawe mwami uzotugira abana bawe none muri aka kanya twizeye izina ryawe twizeye ko turi abana bawe twizeye ko turi abaragwa bawe mwami Yesu none mana yacu turasubiye kuba imbere yawe abahungu n'abakobwa mwami turasubiye kuba imbere yawe mwami turazi waraduhamagaye mwami waradutoranije wadukuye kure wadukuye mu byaha wadukuye mu kaboregwe wadukuye mu busambanyi mwami wadukuye mu byaha by'ishano mana yacu kubwo urukundo wadukunze mwami ni nacyo cyatumye utanga umwana wa Yesu Kristo kugira ngo umwizera wese ntazapfe rubi ariko azahabwa ubugingo budashira turabigushimiye mwami none iryo zina nyine niryo twizeye twizeye mana nzima ko amaraso yiwe atweza twizeye ko twamaze guharirwa ibyaha mwami none mana nzima twarahamaze guharirwa ibyaha turagusabye ngo urushirize kubana natwe ugendane natwe mwami mu bikorwa byacu bya misi yose mana turakwiyegereje mwami ugendane natwe ube muri twebwe natwe tube muri wewe mwami turazi satani we ngo nasinzira agenda tugerageza ariko mana yacu turazi wewe uri muri twebwe urakomeye nta na kimwe cyo kunanira mwami ushobora byose uzi byose uba hose mana yacu nicyo gituma tutakekeranya mwami kuko ijambo ryawe riratubwira ngo ntidutinye uri kumwe natwe mwami none turagushima mana yacu ko watubereye insinzi turagushima Yesu wacu ko wemeye kwikorera ibyaha byacu mwami ndetse ukavuga uti byose 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 birarangiye abanyozo kwizera bose mwami bari mu migisha yawe mana yacu none twizeye wewe mana none turagushima no kuri uno munsi mwami turagushima yuko warunze insinzi urufungo ntirwashoboye kugumya mwami ndetse egome umumarayika yaraje atembagaza ikibuye cyari kuri yamva mwami urazuka mwami umaze kuzuka wiyereka abigishwa bawe mwami mana yacu urababwira uti amahoro abe muri mwebwe mwami none natwe uratwiyereka mwami turabizi neza ugenda utwiyereka mu mirimo ya misi yose mu bikorwa bya misi yose tugenda tukubona mwami tugenda tubona ikiganza cyawe cyiza mwami tugenda tubona urukundo rwawe mana yacu turagusabye natwe mwami ayo mahoro mwami wasezeraniye abigishwa biwe turagusabye mwami ayo mahoro natwe abe muri twebwe abe mu mitima yacu mwami tugendere mu buntu bwawe tugendere mu bazi zawe mwami ubuntu bwawe n'imbabazi zawe bitukomeko mwami kuko tumenya neza mwami turi kumwe nawe mana yacu nacyo tuzokwigira tubura mwami urakoze mwami uri ubuhungiro bwacu uri umufasha atabura guseruka mwami watugiriye neza mwami waranesheje mwami natwe tuzogenda tunesha ku bwawe mwami rero uduhe ikiganza cyiza muri urugendo turimo mwami dufite ukwizigira mwami no muri ubugingo turimo muri uyu mibiri turimo muri iyi mibiri ipfa mwami turamenya mwami imana yuko Yesu wazutse nawe kubw'ubushobozi bwawe mwami ku bwawe mana yacu tuzozuka mana yacu turagusabye rero ngo uduhe muhemu wawe yera turushize kwama imbuto zikwiranye no kwihara no kugororoka mwami uru rugendo twatanguye mwami ugende udushoboza mwami tubandanye urugendo mwami agakiza twahawe mwami tukumire ko ubuntu watugiriye mwami tubugenderemwo ijambo ryawe turigenderemwo mwami tugende tukubaha tugende dukora ibyo ugomba mwami kugira ngo mana yacu niwaza gutora ishengero ryawe mwami ishengero ryawe nato twese mwami tuze tugusanganire uze wandika amazina yacu mu gitabo cyawe cy'ubugingo mwami nitwashiki wawe mwami tuze turonke ingero ikwiranye no kwihara no kugororoka mwami uzobukoze mana yacu mana turagusabye ngo utugirire neza mwami turasenga ishengero ryawe mwami turasabye muhemu wawe yera we yamagenda dushoboza yamagenda twigisha yamagenda twereka ibyo dukwiye kuvuga ibyo dukwiye gukora mana tukiri muri ubugingo mwami turasatani nkuko wabwiye Kaini ngo icakibunze ku rugi we aracabunze mwami ariko mu izina rya Yesu Kristo ndazi ko atabubasha dufise ko nicyo gituma mana nzima ijambo ryawe tubwira ngo ntiduhagarike imitima twizere Imana imuhira kwa data hari amazu menshi wagiye kuyategura kugira ngo ahuzoba n'abo twariho tuzoba mana turabigushimiye kuri iyo sezerano mwami none ndasengeye ishengero ryawe mwami ndasengeye abarongozi ndasengeye abaririmbyi ndasengeye abana bato ndasengeye abigeme ndasengeye abahungu mu izina rya Yesu Kristo ishengero ryose ndarisengeye mwami kugira ngo duhe kugendera mu buntu bwawe mwami uduhe kurushizaho kwama imbuto zikwiranye no kugira no kugororoka mwami kugira ngo mana yacu twame tugendera mu nzira y'ukuri twame dukurikira Yesu kuko Yesu ari we nzira n'ukuri n'ubugingo kandi atawunda zo dushikana kwa data atariwe urakoze mwami turasengeye abagwaye turasengeye abarushe turasengeye bari mu ngendo turasengeye ababuze ababo turasengeye bari mu marira turasengeye abihebuye mu izina rya Yesu Kristo wewe ni uremesha mwami wewe ni ushobora kuremesha mwami ibyo abantu batoshobora mwami mu izina rya Yesu Kristo turazi ko bishobora none mana yacu wikorera ibitangaza mwami abantu bawe bakumenye abantu bawe bagendane nawe mwami bizere izina ryawe tumenye ko tutarabisi mwami ariko turabo mugambi bw'umwijuru mwami hamwe wagenda kutegurira mwami urakoze mana yacu uduhezagire indwi turangubye tudumwe mwami uzuyihezagire mwami uyu minsi turimo mwami uzuyihezagire mwami uyu mwaka turimo mwami uzuduhezagire mwami tugende turushida kubona no kwama imbuto zikwiranye no kwihana no kugoroka mana yacu urakoze uduhezagire twese uwo twanseri satani uwo twirukanye n'imigabo yiwe satana azana ibyaha satana azana ibyago satana azana amagisida satana ateza ubwibone satana ateza ibyaha by'uburyo bwose mu izina rya Yesu Kristo turamwigije kure turamubohesheje mwami turasabye amaraso yawe Yesu wabandanya tuboneka ko urakoze kudukunda urakoze kuduhezagiye mwami ikindi gihe cyiza mana yacu ube muri twebwe natwe tube muri wewe ubikore nk'ugomba mu izina rya Yesu Kristo umucunguzi wacu amen.
As our Savior has taught us, we are confident to pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Well, our life as a community continues. Thank you for joining us for worship and for your prayerful support of what we do, and know that you have our prayers for you, the extended parish family, as you live as the people of God in your place. Here in this place, we've got a men's barbecue breakfast coming up on Saturday morning, the 29th of April, in the hall and on the veranda. We're inviting men to join us and have a barbecue breakfast together and to reflect on how older men can contribute to the life of younger men. Barbecue breakfast, 29 April. A week or so later, in St. John's Cathedral, there will be a choral evensong on Sunday, the 7th of May, to celebrate the coronation of King Charles III, a significant event in the nation, in the world, and for the church, and to be marked in some way. I suspect that most of you, like me, will just watch the coronation at home on television. Whether you're a Republican or a Royalist, it's going to be a big event and important to witness it. But as a church, as a diocese, there will be a choral evensong on Sunday the 7th of May, and the cathedral will be live streaming that, and there'll be a link to that cathedral live streaming site in the side of the notices in a few moments. Well, thank you once again for joining us. I look forward to seeing you next week. As we come to the close of our worship together this time, I'd just like to draw your attention to the Paschal candle, which is burned here in our midst to remind us of the presence of the risen Jesus in our hearts and in our midst. This blessing also encourages us to remember the presence of Jesus. Almighty God, who redeemed us through the resurrection of Christ, and has brought us out of slavery into everlasting freedom, give you joy and peace in faith, and bring you to your eternal inheritance. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be among us and remain with us always. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. In the name of Christ, alleluia, alleluia.
I just want to share with you one of our proudest moments as a parish. About 5 or 6 years ago, we had the Bishop of Ethiopia come and do a mission, Grant Lamarkand and his wife Wendy, talked about their missional experience in Ethiopia, and we took up a collection while they were here. They took it back to Ethiopia, and they rebuilt the Anglican church in the town of Kaffa, St. Matthew's. Kaffa is where the coffee bean, caffeine, comes from. So here in the Anglican parish of Logan, we built the Anglican church in ground zero for coffee. How good does your day have to get after that?